This is an electrical panel. All your circuit breakers are in here. In order for an electrician to work on this, he has to remove the front cover plate. First thing he's going to pick up, the wrong tool. It's not too bad if he removes these using a cordless. It's when he goes to put them back in that's the problem. These have a fairly wide slot, takes a big screwdriver, which is fairly clumsy. They're also set up to take a square drive, and these are pretty handy. One thing electricians don't like about these is they tend to have long threads. The other problem with these is they tend to be self-tapping screws for a lot of these panels. First thing he's going to do, take the cordless, just start driving them in there. He's in a hurry. This panel has four screws, a lot of them will have six or eight. This is your panel. Make him do what you want. Put that fastener in there, turn it backwards, click, and run it in there. And preserve the threads. Takes a little time. It's your panel. Make him do what you want. This is an electrical outlet box. It'll hold a wall outlet or a wall switch. These are inside your wall. They've been nailed to a stud, usually. There are different types. And then there's drywall on the outside of this. When they come in, they cut a hole in here so that you can access the wires and put in the outlet. Attaching the outlet is usually where a problem is, where you have an outlet that won't tighten up or keeps falling out of the box. And when it falls out of the box, it usually brings the cover plate with it. The biggest problem is the fact that these are made out of cheap plastic, but they're everywhere. So we need to learn how to deal with that. These outlets and these switches only cost 50 cents or a dollar each when you buy them in bulk at some of the hardware stores. There's no telling what electrician will charge you to replace one of these. Almost all of these have a screw head that will take a flat blade screwdriver, a Phillips, or a square drive. This is a number one square drive. The square drive I used on the electric panel was a number two. This makes it real easy to control and gives a very positive drive. First thing an electrician will try to use is a cordless screwdriver. These turn too fast. If it's a low speed cordless screwdriver, it's not too bad, especially for running some of these long threads back out of this box. Just how long that thread is going to determine how thick the drywall is and how well this box was installed in the first place. Sometimes you'll have to get a longer screw to make up for the extra thickness. These are 632 threads on all of these outlets and switches. The problem is, this piece of plastic from here to here is 3/8 of an inch long. When I stick my screw in there, there's no place for it there's no material for that to thread into, and I've used up half of that thickness. So all of these screws are threading into a mere 3/16 of an inch thickness, and it's plastic. And this is nailed into your wall. If you damage this box, you're not going to be able to replace it, because this is not only nailed to the wall, but it's also in there with all these wires. So the easiest thing is to take care of this plastic. Most of these will cut their own threads, and the first time you install these, especially the original screws that come with the outlets, they're a little bit tapered here on the end. So that thread, it'll start cutting its own thread. Now when we take this out, and then we go to reinstall it, there's two things we got to do. Time the threads, turn it backwards until it clicks, and then run it in slowly. This is too fast. All that's going to do is wear out or melt plastic. Run it in slowly and time the threads, and then when this is drawn up tight, do not over tighten that. You only have 3/16 of an inch thickness. just snug it up. Most of these outlets that will not tighten up are falling out of the box. These threads have been stripped and damaged. There's one last salvation for this problem. The original screws that go on there are 632. You can buy a larger 832. That 832 will start cutting the thread at the surface of this outlet box. I start running that in there, drive it in slow. That will hold that electrical outlet or the switch firmly. Again, don't use a cordless screwdriver. And I would suggest I would get a 832 tap, and I would run that tap in there slowly, back it out slowly, and then thread these in. If you mess up the threads in here the second time, then you've got a problem. Time your threads. Avoid the problems.